We at the MA Network are indeed privileged to have Dr. Krishna Ella as our inaugural speaker. Dr. Ella, thank you so much for taking time out from your schedule. While he needs no introduction, but I'd still like to definitely highlight his impressive list of awards. Dr. Ella is a recipient of more than 100 national and international awards, which include JRD Tata Best Entrepreneur of the Year, ET Now Special Recognition for Healthcare Industry Award, Best Innovative Company of the Year by Biospectrum, Best Technology and Innovation Award by the Prime Minister of India 2008, and Business Leader of the Year, Pharma Bio World 2011. Before I hand over to Dr. Ella, I request you again to keep your devices on mute so you can hear Dr. Ella clearly. Ladies and gentlemen, welcoming the Chairman and Managing Director of Bharat Biotech International Limited, Dr. Krishna Ella, sharing the story himself, the journey of a vaccine from lab to market. Over to you, Dr. Ella.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Shivangi. And I think it's really an honor to be representing, talking to the Mumbai Angels. I consider Mumbai Angels, angel investor, is a very pivotal importance in the developing an entrepreneurship globally, I'm telling you. I'll tell you my own example. Two angel investors, two medical doctors in US, they gave me $150,000 each when I was not even incorporated a company. And they gave me a check. They said, just do it, something what can be done for the country. Do it whatever you like to do. Do it. And that just spirit of that angel investor is the way it made me to come back to India and then start Bharat Biotech. So I am from a small farming family from Tamil Nadu. I'm not a rich guy. So I started from the humble with these two, three angel investors from US has inspired me to make it to happen to come back to India. I think, you know, the Mumbai Angel wants me to cover three different things. One is innovation, and the second is interdisciplinary approach, particularly IoT and others field in building up the life sciences. The third is regulatory environment, three topics they asked me to talk, but I'll touch upon briefly on that. I will ask a simple question. My professor at University of Wisconsin told me, science, you should think in simple language. If you think in simple language, you'll find the biggest solutions in the world. If you start thinking in a complex manner, you will never find the solutions in life. Okay? The problem in India is we think in science in very complex manner. And that's why we don't find a lot of solutions in India at all. I'll tell you innovation. What is it? I say, I don't want to give a definition to the people because very esteemed participants are there in that meeting, in the meeting right now. I'll say simple language. It's composed of three things. One, imagination. Second is knowledge. Third is skill. Imagination is a very simple language. I will tell you very simple, simplest manner. Imagination, you look at Lord Ganesha. I'm not talking about a religious perspective on this matter. Please note down that one. And when you see Lord Ganesha, what do you see? It's just imagination power. You see an elephant head on the human body. So that means a transplantation. It's just a transplantation. A kidney, liver is also organ. Head is also organ. Is that possible, an organ transplant? You all know that it's happening in the science now. You look at Golconda Port in Hyderabad, 4 kilometers down, somebody can shout, and 4 kilometers down, you can hear it. That means there was no sound engineers, there was no IITs those days, but the sort of imagination of sound, it can travel. That's the imagination power. The second thing is knowledge. Knowledge is nothing but a degree. How much is useful to your degree? The Chinese doesn't know good enough about the English language, but they're extremely good in knowledge. And coming to third important aspect of it, which is countries lacking, is a skill set. And that is where Chinese are dominating in the field. In terms of they can't even speak English, they have a good knowledge of degree and good skill set. That skill set is what is making them the best of in science and technology in the world right now. They're beating everybody in the world. And coming to US, US got all three components of it, imagination, and at the young children level, they will ask you to write a small, 5 years old, 6 years old, I've seen my daughter, asked to write on one show on some statue, ask them to write 10 pages. A child will be asked to try to talk 10 pages. It's not an easy task. They write that 10 pages. So that sort of imagination we have to build from the school level onwards in this country. That is where we're missing. We are a competition exam driven. Somebody BCom fellow, one fellow fail, one fellow pass, he writes one IAS exam and he becomes an IAS officer. So that is not right for the country. You need to create a imagination and knowledge and skills are very, very critical. I will tell you, where is another thing, what it needs for the, to create the innovation. Observation is a very important. Many of Indians, we think we are intelligent. We speak too much and we talk too much. And we don't even watch. We are on mobile phone all the time. We are on email all the time. And we don't observe things. And very good example is, you look at orange juice. The orange juice that what we drink in India, we think because it's Americans are drinking, Europeans are drinking, so we're also drinking orange juice. Whatever orange juice you are drinking is not coming from Indian farmers at all. It is whatever the juice, Nagpur Santra, is grown as a fruit, not as a juice. A simple example, canola oil. Canola oil is Canadian oil. $120 billion brand of canola oil is nothing but mustard oil of India. But they don't want to call mustard oil Canadian. They call canola oil. A simple observation and simple thinking. And I always want people to simple thinking. That's very simple, I'll tell you. We don't have even chutney, ready-made chutney in this country. Forget about it. We're eating samosa. All our people were eating samosa with chutneys, pudina chutney or whatever the chutney was. And now we're eating with ketchup. Now we are calling, the ketchup country now. And we don't have even chutney making in this country properly. So the, simple thinking, simple observation will make people to visualize a lot of things. And a skill set. And I think, Chinese are dominating the skill set without even English language. We have dominated in English language, but not dominated in the skill set. That is where we are fair problem. How to increase the skill? This innovation angle. Free exchange of people is important. And unfortunately, Indians are highly insecure people. We are insecure of teaching something to others. Am I? Okay, and then our curriculum also has to be changed. And I think it needs to be focused more than a degree. It has to be skill set, has to be molded. That's an important thing on my second, first topic. Second is, how do you increase operational experience, excellence by using interdisciplinary? That is also very bad in this country. Chemistry, people doesn't talk to biology. Biology people doesn't talk to chemistry. IIT doesn't only have engineering. Maybe they are building slowly life sciences, but it's not a life science school, IITs. So that's the sad part, okay? And I think, UDCT, you look at in Bombay, you look at IACT, you look at NCL Pune, they are chemistry oriented. It doesn't work anywhere in the world. You look at in US also, whether it's MIT, Harvard, MIT was an engineering school. Today it has become one of the best life science school also. Harvard was a medical school. Now it became a best life science school also. So I think we need to think different interdisciplinary is very important. The Mumbai Angels asked me to talk about IoT. I'm not a field expert, but I think this is one of the earliest field where Indians are so good in IT and good in, may not be good in hardware, but this is where we need to integrate a little bit hardware and manufacturing experiences of this country. And I think, like a sequence data, it's available from China, US, Europe, everybody's available. If somebody's smart in creating a big database and you can create your own intellectual properties. The equipments that are manufactured in the manufacturing facility, whether vaccine or chemistry, how do you integrate to IoT where you can maintain from Bombay or you can maintain from Pune or anything sitting in Hyderabad? These sort of new ideas, simple ideas, you need to work with IoT, IT people, should work with the manufacturing people. And I think, you are going to look at an IT business like a plug in the computer, get the business contract business from US, it's not going to solve the problem. You need to work with Indian manufacturers, build science around the IoT and other field. And even 3D manufacturing is going to revolutionize the field in terms of pharma delivery. Earlier we had a pharma compounder. They used to make 2-3 drugs mixing. And now 3D manufacturing has been, our guidelines has come in FDA already. So now future is going to come. You have a cancer drug, 2-3 drugs. You're going to mix it and going to make a tablet, personalized tablet for the human beings. And 2-3 combination. So the change, concepts are changing. And I think we need to be aware of the type of thing. And medical devices, you're saying the mobile phone, watches can feel the blood pressure, cardiac rhythm, all those things. Already you're seeing that IoT, how it is impacting the life sciences in this thing. And I think people need quite a bit of imagination power to understand how this can help a poor people, whether Indian agriculture, Indian dairy, where this IoT can go in the field. And I think for the people to imagine things. And I always say, you need a manufacturing also simple thinking, and a great opportunity is available in the manufacturing. When India is going to be very big in manufacturing segment, if IoT can be combined, and that would be amazing. Simple thing like IITs are sitting in this country. Unfortunate, IITs are not even thinking about disposable fermenter. Today, the world is changing into disposable plastic bag. Is nothing but a plastic bag with the two probes, with a pH probe and DO probe, nothing else in this technology. Even the plastic bag is not manufactured in India. I don't know why IITs are sitting there. And why IIT is not doing these sort of jobs is a question we need to ask ourselves. These are the simple ideas. Should be put in engineering and chemistry and biologists should work together, put to country in a simple technology. I always tell, again, simple thinking. It's a very important. Coming to my third topic was a regulatory. Regulatory is the one thing India loves. Every government officer wants to have a regulation in this country. That's a sad part of it. And it's inevitable right now. I mean, political system, very proactive in this country to implement a lot of changes. But somewhere, the political commitment and the entrepreneurs level between the two are not happening. That's a sad part of it. Look at it in biotechnology. I need even one animal I want to test it. I need a permission called Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. Even one R&D material I want to import from US for plasmid also, Institutional Biosafety Committee and RCHM permission. Even R&D material you want to import. I mean, I don't know why India loves regulation. And that regulation is choking us. You know, regulation is important for country's safety point of view. I'm not denying that. But it has to be a simple regulation, where it doesn't hurt everybody viewed, every entrepreneur viewed as a suspiciously as a terrorist. You cannot view that. And I think you need to think in a simple way. The regulator has subject expert committees and expert GEC committees. There's so many committees after committees. You go out to through at least more than 35 committees. Pollution Control Board has got a committees. Labor Commissioners has got a committees. And you have a metrology. You want me to weight of my vaccine vial is also measured is a metrology department. You know, hundreds of regulatory handle. But I think, you know, political will is there, but somewhere we are missing the political will translating into ground level. And I think my example is as an entrepreneurship. My mom and my wife told me, son, you have make 9 inches stomach. You have 9 inches stomach. How much of your money you make in US, you come back, I'll feed your stomach. That's all one philosophy. That one philosophy made me to take a risk. Today, we are taking Covaxin and Cororab, other COVID vaccine. We have an option to contract manufacturing for multinationals. But we choose a method that we will not manufacture for others. Let us develop ourselves. Because India needs self-security, national security to be protected. And we should manufacture ourselves. We should develop our own product and make it happen for country. And thank you very much, Mumbai Angel, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ella. Thank you for taking time out. This was a very, very inspiring talk. We hope that you will continue to stay with us for some time.